When you do a targeted list, you can pick different types of motivations. And so we typically start with an absentee owner and a vacant property owner. And so absentee and or vacant property owners, because they make up the largest segment of potentially motivated sellers of all the different types. You have different types like probates, inherited, other inherited properties, code violations, tax delinquency, expires, withdrawn listings, FSBOs for sale by owners, FRBOs for rent by owners, and others. I'm not going to go through all of them. Expires and withdrawns and cancels are really, really good targets to market to right now. If you're not marketing to them, we highly encourage you to do so. And we're actually making expires and withdrawns and canceled lists available to our deal finders, you know, for their campaigns. So you really need to target these different types of motivations. Sometimes you can stack them, like have a vacant house and also be in pre-foreclosure as an example. It's called stacking a list. And so Carswell will actually show you where Carswell fell in. And again, you want to start your marketing with at least 5,000 absentee and or vacant properties, because you have to fill the top of your funnel with enough prospects so that as they contact you back and you follow up, that you have enough people in the pipeline that actually can trickle down, you know, to actually have a deal. So I did some research, Lakeisha, and it was actually interesting in how you came in contact with the owner for Carswell. And so with Carswell, that particular owner, when you did your Done For You campaign, that owner actually received your Are You Selling message because they owned a different property. Now, we redacted out the actual address here, but that owner owned a property on Riggs Avenue in Baltimore. And you can see here by the SDAT record, SDAT is State Department of Assessment and Taxation. And every city or county has their own Department of Assessment and Taxation, you know, where they keep real property records. And so in Baltimore City, it's housed by the state of Maryland. And so you can go and look up any property and you can see this property on Riggs Avenue that the owner is not it's not their principal residence. You can see highlighted, it says no for principal residence. That means they're an absentee owner because they don't live at the property. And so you can see their mailing address is a Baltimore address is 21216, and the property address is 21217 on Riggs Avenue. So why do I show you this? I'm showing you this to show you that the first contact that Lakeisha and the virtual assistants made with this property owner was actually asking if they're interested in selling the property on Riggs Avenue. It wasn't Carswell. So, but that's often happens is when you're marketing to someone that's potentially motivated because they have a vacant property or an absentee property, a lot of times investors own more than one property. In fact, the average investor owns about four to five properties. So you're likely to find when you have a motivated seller that they may be motivated to sell not just one property, but you know, maybe others. So do you remember this exchange, Lakeisha, with having that initial pivot from the Riggs Avenue to now talking about 1500 Carswell?
Yeah, a little bit. I think it was something basic as, you know, the owner telling me that this wasn't the property that they were looking to sell, but they had another property available. And they gave me the address of the 1500 Carswell and we went from there.
Yep. And that often will happen. So as long as you're marketing people that are motivated, you're going to find that to happen a lot. So what happens is when you take a targeted list, like a list of vacant houses or a list of absentee houses, you're going to get, just like you saw on the SDAT record, you're going to get the mailing address, the owner's name, the property address, but you have to have contact information like their phone number or email to actually market to them. So that process is called skip tracing. And so if you start out with 5,000 like absentee and or vacant properties, you have to then get their phone numbers or contact information. So that process is called like skip tracing the list. So a list is no good without contact information. So, you know, with our Done For You campaigns, our Deal Finders Challenge, we'll skip trace the list for you. So you have 5,000 prospects, potentially motivated sellers, and you have at least one phone number for those motivated sellers. And so that comes, you know, with our campaigns. The basic premise of skip tracing is you're taking a targeted list, and you can do this for any industry, and then you just want to match those records, the owner and then the address, with, you know, quality databases. So you can get the highest quality landlines, cell numbers, email addresses, social media profiles, and then you're able to contact them. Hopefully you can contact them, you know, via phone first, you know, and before you have to go the route of, let's say, direct mail and things of that nature. So with our Done For You campaigns, the skip tracing comes included with the campaigns. And then it's all about, once you have the contact information, then it's all about contacting them. So Lakeisha, have you ever tried to take a list yourself and to do the either cold calls yourself or to do texting yourself, like going one by one?
Oh, absolutely.
So why don't you share that experience with people that have not yet done it before or they're thinking about trying to do it themselves?
Yeah, well, you know, with cold calling, it's a matter of one, whether or not the person is motivated, then two, whether or not you can actually reach the person and what time you're actually making those phone calls. In doing cold calls, you know, I find that often people will not pick up their phones immediately. So you get a lot of voicemail messages. And so, you know, the process of cold calling is just, in my opinion, very grueling because I'm sitting there, you know, ideally I want to make phone calls 2 to 3 hours per day, but there are other things that I could be doing with my time. And so, you know, that was a part of the reason that I decided to hire a virtual assistant, because that's a little bit too much of my time to utilize making phone calls when I can focus on other areas within my business.
Absolutely. So things like sending text messages, doing cold calls, these are all things that work in terms of funnel marketing. But you have what I think are higher and better uses of your time. You, Lakeisha, and everyone else on the call here, because as a small business owner, you can be strategizing, having conversations with private money partners. You could be actually evaluating some, you know, some deals to actually negotiate, and the things that are grunt work, like, you know, the qualifying of a motivated seller using a seller questionnaire, the back and forth phone tag in terms of cold calling. These are things you can outsource to a virtual assistant. And that's what we do, you know, with our Done For You Deal Finders Challenge. So what you have on the screen here is, you know, essentially, you know, it's what the challenge and what the Done For You campaigns are all about. It's setting up automation, funnel automation, so that you have auto dialers that are synced with seller questionnaire and call scripts, where virtual assistants now can do some of the grunt work for you. So with our Deal Finders Challenge, this starts with those 5,000 targeted records Lakeisha was talking about targeting. In this case, you were targeting Baltimore with your campaign, right?
Yes.
Okay, so targeting Baltimore, vacant properties, 5,000 records, you get the phone numbers and contact information, we'll skip trace it, and then we have our Deal Finders funnel with the automation set up to actually do the funnel marketing for her. So, you know, once you have the list in the system, you have the dialer, you have the everything set up with the follow-up. So that's what enables Lakeisha, her deal VA, our VAs as well, to have things be set up with automation, with follow-up that's on scheduled timelines. So if a call goes out or text goes out, if there's no response, there can be automation for it to automatically follow up in 7 days, automatically follow up in 14 days, automatically follow up in 30 days, and keep track of that with CRM type management. So our Deal Finders funnel has a lot of cool triggers, smart automation, and our challenge, our 30-day challenge, comes with the funnel automation set up by our tech team and then our deal VAs to do all the follow-up for your campaign. So with the automation, you have a mix of different types of Are You Selling messages. You have ringless voicemails, which can be conversation starters. You have text messages, you know, which can be a very good way to get in touch with sellers. You have outbound cold calls, which is another way to get in touch with sellers. And these are the typical preferred ways to reach sellers directly before going to things like direct mail, because direct mail can be more expensive on a per direct mail postcard or per direct mail yellow letter basis. Although direct mail is very effective. It's just that most people wait to do direct mail until they can't reach the seller by other means, the means I mentioned, ringless voicemails, text messages or cold calls. But the bottom line is you have to have automation. You have to have a system that is reaching out to these prospects all these different ways in order for you to get a hold of the seller. So let's take a look. Now, Lakeisha, you didn't know I was going to do this, but what I'm showing you here is, and she probably doesn't even know this data down to this granular level, but it's so important for you guys to understand this point. Now, what we're showing you right now on this slide is the number of contacts from March 31st and through June, where we are now. And so what we're looking at is we're looking at the total number of contacts, the green being outbound text messages, the red being inbound text messages, and the purple one being the one at the bottom being a qualified lead, being a seller questionnaire that's been completed. And so, Lakeisha, would it surprise you that with this owner of this property, 1500 Carswell, that you had a total of 140 messages with this particular prospect? Would that surprise you?
Actually, it would not.
140, folks. 140. That's a one and a four and a zero. That's how many times Lakeisha and her virtual assistant, or our deal VAs, our virtual assistants, combined total has communicated back and forth with this particular seller. Now, you heard me say it takes usually 7 to 14 times touches back and forth. In this case, it took 140 back and forth touches. Now, the question I had to you, was it worth it?
Oh, absolutely. Yes.
Okay. All right. So most of those communications were via text, as people can see, the green. So
right.
before we move forward, so just how did that work? And I'm actually going to show some screenshots, but just how does it work, you know, communicating, you know, via text? Did you find it easier? Does the seller find it easier via text? You know, just kind of walk people through just how that interaction works and has worked with you and the seller of this product.
Yeah, actually, I think because the seller does work full time during the day, I found that texting was much easier for the seller versus a phone call. And we actually did have a couple of phone calls, but it just seemed to work better for our communication that we did text messaging back and forth.
Okay. And so the cool thing about that is the actual texting all takes place inside the funnel. So it's all housed inside the funnel, all under one tracking system where Lakeisha can see the back and forth as well as the VAs that are working with her. So let's continue on. If you have any questions, by the way, I see some questions here. I'm going to get through all the questions. So drop your questions if you have them. I'll make sure I come back and get to each one. So again, we're talking to Lakeisha Alston, one of our Deal Mastery students, talking about an active campaign. We're going inside the funnel, a leads to deal case study. It's Andre Johnson here with our Deal Mastery Monday funnel call. So let's go ahead and continue on. So you have to have these virtual assistants. Lakeisha hired her own. We have our own investor trained VAs, but you have to have virtual assistants that will do these Are You Selling prospecting calls and text replies for you. So if you start with 5,000 prospects, like Lakeisha says, she has a 9-to-5. She is an investor agent. She has a retail business. She has an investor business. So you can't do all of this by yourself. So most people I know, because I communicate with many of you, I am an investor myself, of course. Most people hate sales calls. You hate having to do cold calls yourself. Most people hate receiving cold calls. Most people don't like doing cold calls because you don't feel comfortable. You don't know what to say. But why do businesses still do cold calls? Any answers? Because they work. They still work. That's the thing about cold calls. That's why they'll never stop, is cold calls work, because there's nothing like a person-to-person conversation. And so what our investor-trained VAs will do is they'll take your 5,000 motivated seller targeted list, vacants and or absentees, and they will do the back and forth calls. They'll do the replies, the text replies, the callbacks to qualify the sellers as motivated. And the people that respond to your initial Are You Selling messages, our VAs will then qualify them with a seller questionnaire, and then you get real-time notification of the motivated seller lead. So, Lakeisha, in your funnel, do you get real-time notifications via email only, or do you get text and email notifications?
I actually get text and email notifications.
Okay, so that's an option. Like, some people don't like text notifications. Honestly, you know, our VAs are able to qualify so many leads that some people don't like getting that many text messages. I mean, I know it sounds silly, right? To not want to get notified of motivated seller leads that come in your system, but some people prefer to get email only notifications. That's totally, you know, your preference, you know, your choice, but you have within the Deal Finders funnel, you have the ability to get a real-time notification of a lead coming in, and you can get that notification via email or text. And so when the deal VAs get a lead qualified, they'll typically get the information in a seller questionnaire. They'll get the seller's contact information, the property details, property condition. They ask for the motivation why the owner is selling. They typically will qualify the seller, if possible, on their flexibility on price and terms. They don't ask, are you flexible on price and terms? They ask, you know, very crafty questions like, you know, if we can close all cash quickly, you know, are you willing to accept some money at closing and the rest, let's say, in a year or so? And so the answers to questions like that, you know, really tell you as an investor. And then if you're using our deal closers, it lets us know whether there's an opportunity for seller financing, taking up repayments, or some types of creative financing. And so the investor trained deal VAs really qualify and get this type of information for you so that you're able to, when you get the qualified lead, just go ahead and go right into solving their problem, whatever it is. So the cool thing about working with us with our Done For You campaigns, our Texting Tuesday campaigns, with our Deal Finders Challenge, is that you never have to pay for interviewing virtual assistants, hiring virtual assistants, training virtual assistants. You never have to pay for virtual assistants' hourly wages. And it's really, really helpful to have a system that's set up with trained, expert staff that can do all this for you. And then you can just get real-time notifications of the leads that are coming in. So we're going to take a look right now at the text exchange that Lakeisha had with the actual sellers.